Last night, the Royals' king crowned Andy Pettit twice. And after four straight wins, it looked like the Yankees' lefty was ready for a tumble. But Tino came to the rescue once again, giving the Yankees three runs with one swing. Casey's bid for a comeback was squashed as Scott Brosius stepped on third for a double play, leaving the Royals skipper steamed and calling for some luck of his own. And then the straw stepped out from the dugout and put the game out of reach. Just another ho-hum win. Today, the Bombers look for the sweep next. MSG Network presents New York Yankees Baseball. And this afternoon, the Yankees take on the Kansas City Royals in the third game of a three-game set. The Yankees have the brooms out looking for the sweep. It'll be Ramiro Mendoza, the right-hander, against the veteran right-hander for the Royals, Tim Belcher. It is a gorgeous day here in Middle America. About mid-70s and perfect baseball weather, shirt-sleeve crowd as they look for the Royals to try to snap out of this funk that they're in. And the Yankees are putting a lot of teams in funks, I'll tell you that. They have won 18 of their last 20. They're playing great baseball, and they're doing it all without the home run from Bernie Williams and Paul O'Neill. But who knows, that might happen today. But you really can't be that picky. Last night, the Yankees had it all, winning 12-6, and that's their 18th win in their last 20. And the big, big blow, though, the one that they're always going to remember, is going to be Darryl's home run. But before that, you're going to look at the controversy on the tag-up play. Here it is right now. It's the sixth inning, a fly ball to Paul O'Neill. Mike Sweeney is at third base. You watch. O'Neill makes the catch. That's when Sweeney leaves. But third base umpire Brian Onora, he didn't think so. The throw was late, but when the Yankees appealed, they said out, so it was a double play. Tony Musa said, you're wrong, Onora, and he got tossed. And he was angry. But then it was all pretty much for naught because Darryl Strawberry comes off the bench in the ninth inning, out of the clubhouse, into the batter's box, and he hits a grand slam to put the game away. It's really been that sort of season for the Yankees. And, you know, for us, though, we always want to have our first team. The Knicks, they don't have Larry Johnson today. They don't have Mills, been suspended. But we have the size, we have the depth, and we have our first team up in the broadcast booth right now. The two big guys, Ken Singleton and Jim Cott, they'll call all the action. Hey, guys.
All right, thanks a lot, Michael. Thanks for that good report from field level. The Yankees are a very professional group. Right now, they know that everything is going their way, but in the back of their mind, they know they have to stay prepared every game and not let go. And probably one of the most professional hitters they have in that lineup is Tino Martinez.
Not only professional, but one of the hottest hitters as well. Tino Martinez got off to a little bit of a slow start like the ball club did on the West Coast, but ever since the Yankees returned home, the Yankee Stadium, he has been on fire. The other night against the Seattle Mariners, a game-winning hit in the 10th inning, and last night here, Tino was on fire again, had three hits in the ball game, and came through with one of the biggest hits of the night against the Royals here in Kansas City. Three-run shot, they're trying to pitch him inside, hasn't been working for the Royals. This one gave the Yankees a 6-2 lead at the time. They were on their way to the 12-6 win, and Tino Martinez has been one of the hottest hitters in the league.
Last night, 3-for-5 with a home run and three RBIs, and there's the season stats. Second in the American League on his way to another MVP-type season. Well, not a lot to cheer about if you're a Kansas City Royals fan, but they have one of the great baseball names and one of the exciting young players in the league, and Johnny Damon coming off a four-hit game.
And his manager, Tony Musa, made a move with Johnny Damon last year. He moved him to the top of the order when Bob Boone was managing. Johnny Damon was batting 6th and 7th. Well, this guy has great speed, and he also has some power. Hit a home run, the only run the Royals got in the opening game on Friday, and last night, he was on fire some more. Four hits in the ball game, including a double. He only had 12 doubles all last year. He has 8 already this season.
The third four-hit game of his career last night. He's having a great series, 5-for-8, 9 doubles in the 1998 season. Well, veteran Tim Belcher will try to stop the bleeding for the Royals. Ramiro Mendoza takes the mound for the Yankees. Yankees trying to get the broom out and sweep this series before they head to Texas. We'll have it for you on MSG when we come back.
America. American Express Small Business Services. How can I help you?
How can I help you?
Right. We only work with small businesses.
Why don't we start with your cash flow?
And our equipment financing plan will help spread out the payments.
That'll definitely give you more flexibility.
How about setting up a line of credit?
We can do that.
Then I'll put you in touch with one of our CPAs so you can start getting ready for tax time.
We can always make adjustments when your situation changes.
Call 1-800-SUCCESS to find out how American Express Small Business Services can help you do more.
Start spreading the news. I'm leaving today. I want to be a part of it. New York, New York. I want to wake up in a city that never sleeps. And find I'm day number one, top of the list, king of the hill, a number one. It's up to you.
The Tax Time Blues. Four and five star tax-free bond funds from American Century. Just call. Thank you. 1-800-660-0092.
Welcome back to Kansas City. That is the discussion between the umpires and Tony Muser. Notice that Chris Chambliss, who took the lineup card up for the Yankees, has already returned to the dugout. And Kenny, we've seen this before. This is one of those situations where Tony Muser wants to get his say in for what happened last night. Well over 2 minutes he's been holding court with the umpires, and I think he's just venting a little frustration. This can't possibly help him for today's game.
No, because you get on the wrong side of the umpires going into a ball game, and the situation with the Royals, they've been struggling. Everybody's struggling against the Yankees. You're going to need all the help you can get today on those close calls. You might get one, but Tony Muser, you know, he's moving his hands, he's bobbing his head, and the fans can see he is somewhat agitated. And the umpires know that. They know that he's, in a way, kind of showing it up.
Yeah, I think the best thing you can do as a manager after a situation like that is come out and say, beautiful day for baseball, isn't it, guys? Let's have a good game, and kind of show them that you've put that behind you. But Muser's had his say. The umpires were very calm. They exchange a little high five at home plate before they take their positions. And we will be set to go here with game three of this three-game series. I saw Muser walk down in the tunnel. I didn't see any ejection sign at home plate. But we're looking right now at veteran Tim Belcher. You see his record in six games. He's had four solid starts and a couple of bad ones. It all adds up to a win and three losses in the rest of the numbers. A classic veteran pitcher. He'll give you lots of innings. He'll give up some hits, some long balls. Yankees remember him from a spring training outing where they pounded him for about nine runs in three innings. And here's the lineup that Joe Torre has posted today to go against the veteran righty. Couple of changes. Homer Bush leads it off. He plays second. Then Jeter O'Neill and Tino Martinez. Bernie Williams bats fifth. Daryl Strawberry's playing left field today and batting sixth. And Tim Raines, Jorge Posada, and Scott Brosius. Starting lineups brought to you by Bob Stores. Great buys on brands you wear.
In the field for the Royals this afternoon on a beautiful day for baseball here in Kansas City. You can see the infield, Palmer, Martinez, Offerman, and King. Turner doing the catching. The outfield, Morris, Damon, and Sutton. Belcher on the mound. And it's going to be Chris Turner. And you can see that the young man with that black eye, he got that. He was hit by a pitch by Juan Guzman in Toronto. And when they took him to the hospital in Toronto, they thought he was a hockey player. They're used to seeing that.
That's right.
Yeah.
Not for baseball. Boy, and he hung in there. He said he just froze, and it pushed that batting helmet right against his eye. But the 29-year-old catcher is behind the plate today. And the first pitch to Homer Bush in for a strike. Chuck Knobloch, as Michael Kay pointed out, bothered a little bit by an old injury, a sort of a bone bruise on the one of the fingers of his glove hand. So he'll get a rest today. Little jam shot up the middle. This could be tough for Offerman, and he's Homer Bush. Continues the everything's going right by the Yankees with a little broken bat single that went about 85 feet to lead off the ball game.
Well, Homer's only had four at bats during the course of the season. He's come on to pinch run and late inning a defensive replacement to give either Knobloch or Jeter a rest. But right here, his third hit of the year. He's only been up five times. He's hitting 600. And plus, when he smells that base hit, he can get down the line. That's why Joe Torre will not hesitate to use him as a pinch runner late in ball games.
So a good start for Homer Bush with a little broken bat single. Derek Jeter will step in. On the run. Stolen base, taking advantage of the inexperienced catcher, and Homer Bush with a great jump. The running Yankees are at it again.
Not hesitating at all. Belcher delivers to the plate and Bush is off and running, and the throw is offline. So there's no chance to get Homer Bush at second base. His first stolen base of the year.
And those of you that have been with us during the first part of the season aware the Yankees are leading the major leagues in stolen bases. Another jam shot. This one's going to be hit hard enough for Offerman to make the play, but it's a productive out as Jeter advances Bush to third. Give you today's umpires lineups. They're brought to you by NAM, the National Arbitration and Mediation, most timely, cost-effective way to settle your legal disputes. Don Dinkinger, the crew chief, Rick Reed, Tim Cheetah, and Brian Onora involved in the controversy last night. He's at second base. Dinkinger, the veteran umpire. And there's Brian Onora. So early on, Tony Muser will play his infield in with one out here in the first inning and try to cut down the potential lead run. Here's O'Neill. Average now over 300. Outside for a ball.
You mentioned that start that Belcher had in spring training where he gave up all the runs to the Yankees. To show you how much spring training means to a veteran pitcher, he came out and went seven shutout innings against Baltimore on opening day at Camden Yards.
Off speed pitch. He is the kind of pitcher that every team in baseball, I think, would like to have on his staff. There's the little scouting report and that classic veteran pitcher. He's got a little Keyshawn Johnson. Just give me the ball. Every 5 days he did not like being taken out of his last start. He's primarily a same speed pitcher, and you know from hitting, if you have a guy that does not change speeds a lot, you feel a little more comfortable against him.
I think what we're seeing right now from Belcher is a veteran type move. He's going to be very careful with Paul O'Neill, and I would think that O'Neill has the hit sign 3-0 with a chance to drive in a run.
And he does, but it's right at King. King can't handle the ball, and Paul O'Neill will reach first base on the air. A little snapshot of how this entire series has gone. Everything right for the Yankees, nothing right for the Royals. One of the best fielding first basemen in baseball can't handle it.
Well, it's a broken bat. O'Neill did have the green light. But watch as King comes up with it cleanly and can't make the throw, and all hands will be safe. In his haste to make the play, Bush was going as soon as the ball was hit. So he was going on contact, and Jeff King trying to make the play couldn't throw the man out.
Wow. And Tino Martinez will step in. Little extra on that little grudge fastball. Tim Belcher's broken two bats and hit Derek Jeter in on the handle. And he's down 1-0 with a man on and only one out.
O'Neill will get an RBI on that play.
Speed pitch in for a strike. Tino said on Friday night the Royals tried to pitch him up and in. Pat Rapp pitched a good game and some cut fastballs, and he was missing him. So he felt like last night the Royals said, we got him out Friday that way, let's try it again. And all three hits he got were on similar pitches up in the strike zone and middle of the plate in.
Adjustments.
There goes O'Neill. Now he bluffs and holds up, but Martinez, another broken bat. O'Neill with that great jump gets to third. The Yankees are running the pillows as well as stealing bases. They're really taking advantage of every opportunity. Three broken bats, three hits, runners at the corners and one out.
Well, let's see where the pitch is. It is a look like a sinker or a changeup going away and off the end of the bat. Tino gets just enough of it. And O'Neill off and running. Then hesitates, sees the line drive the right field, and he's on his way to third. It looked like he felt, maybe didn't feel like he had the jump and held up. But then he sees the ball in the right field in front of Larry Sutton, and the Yankees have runners on the corners.
I don't know where the Yankees stored their bats last night, but they've got three pieces of firewood for the long winter. Bernie Williams, the average over 300. That's low and in for a ball. Everyone concerned about Bernie's power production except Bernie and hitting coach Chris Chambliss. Said, I like the way he's swinging the bat. You probably went through periods like that where you're swinging the bat well, but if you don't quite get it elevated, it doesn't go out of the ballpark.
Yeah, that and plus the fact that, you know, he's been scoring a lot of runs. Had three hits here last year. There's nothing wrong with a three-hit game.
No. It's not like he's the guy in the lineup. They're saying, hey, we're looking to you to hit the long ball. I mean, there come a time when they would like to have him, but I think that the worst thing would be right now for Bernie to get overly concerned with not having a home run.
I think when you think back to last year with Cecil Fielder, they were looking for the home runs from Cecil because that's what he does. Bernie Williams not only hits, he gets on base, steals bases, plays a great center field, a gold glove center field, steals bases. There are more things that he can add to the offense. So that's why you don't get overly concerned with the fact that he hadn't hit a home run yet.
Probably hitting here 3-0 with Strawberry on deck. Four pitch walk. Well, let's check the record books. When's the last time? I guess I might have been there in 1961 when Jim Gentile hit back-to-back Grand Slam home runs.
Well, this is last night in the top of the ninth inning, and that increased the Yankees' lead to 6. A 435-foot grand slam. Minutes before that, Darryl was in the clubhouse, sitting on the couch,
getting mentally prepared. Get on the hands, fouled out of play. That'll reach the seats. I guess another guy that could identify with having an night like that is the bullpen coach Tony Kloninger. What a thrill for a pitcher to hit a couple of grand slams.
Yeah.
O'Neill's at third. Tino Martinez at second. Bernie drew a walk. He's at first. And Belcher ahead in the count 0-2.
I believe Tony Kloninger did that at then Candlestick Park against the San Francisco Giants. Only pitcher ever to hit two grand slams in a ball game. And I think he drove in 9 runs that day.
That's a year's worth for most pitchers. Left field. Morris is coming on, and it's going to be too shallow for O'Neill to try to score. That's the second out of the ballgame. And the Royals finally get a little break. All those broken bat hits, and that went into short left field.
Well, Hal Morris, primarily a first baseman in the National League with the Cincinnati Reds. Over here with Jeff King playing first, Morris has moved to the outfield in DH, and he shows a pretty good arm. Hits the cutoff man right on the numbers.
Tim Raines, the designated hitter today. I think Michael Kay covered that in the interview with Joe Torre. Felt like Strawberry could play left field today on the grass, a complete day off tomorrow. So preserve those knees. Raines loops this out into short left field. Johnny Damon coming on, and he makes a fine sliding catch. Wow, Tim Belcher says there is justice. He gets out of that with one run thanks to that inning-ending grab by Johnny Damon. Another look at it. Yankees lead by 1. Royals coming to bat when we come back on MSG.
Simple and free. Aflac. of reasons to fly today. Only one that matters to you. At Delta Airlines, it is our pleasure to get you to the place you want to be. Delta Airlines, on top of the world.
Nobody does it like you.
Wind Tunnel by Hoover is here. It's breakthrough technology. Tests show it picks up more dirt than any other clean air upright. Nobody. Wind Tunnel by Hoover.
Does it like you.
New York Yankees baseball is brought to you by the irresistible taste that makes you say, did somebody say McDonald's? By American Express. Wherever you are, whatever you're doing, American Express helps you do more. By your Tri-State Jeep and Eagle dealer. There's only one Jeep, and it's only at your Tri-State Jeep and Eagle dealer. And by Nobody Beats the Wiz Home Entertainment Center.
Nice look at Kauffman Stadium. Ideal baseball day. Fresh air, green grass, temperature in the 70s. You're looking at Ramiro Mendoza. Makes his sixth appearance of the year, still looking for win number one. A lot of hits, not too many strikeouts, needs to keep the ball down to be effective. And here's the lineup he'll face. Johnny Damon leads it off, then Jose Offerman, Hal Morris bats third, Jeff King, the veteran Terry Pendleton is the DH. Dean Palmer, Larry Sutton, Chris Turner, and Felix Martinez round it out. First pitch swinging, Johnny Damon fouls it straight back. That one home run came in Friday night's ball game against Hideki Arabu. That's the only run the Royals scored. Mendoza working quickly. That pitch low, and it's 1-1.
Should be able to tell as we look at the scouting report on Ramiro Mendoza what kind of stuff he has. Concentration factor, sometimes caught in between.
Tino, a couple of hops, makes the play, one down.
And we'll check out the defense behind Ramiro this afternoon for the Yankees. And we start in the outfield this time with the Yankees. They're going to have Strawberry in left field, Williams in center, and O'Neill in right. Brosius, Jeter, Bush, Martinez, Posada doing the catching, Mendoza on the mound. Here's a look at Homer Bush, who we've already seen. He's come around and scored the Yankees' first run. Can play second or short. There's plenty of range in the field, and you know, during the course of spring training, you thought he might get cut, but he doesn't have any options left. So the Yankees held on to it.
First pitch to Offerman, low for a ball. Homer grew up in East St. Louis, Illinois, as a St. Louis Cardinal fan. Outside 2-0, and as you might imagine, he said, "I wore number one, and I wanted to play shortstop like Ozzie Smith." That was his original position. Minor leagues. Boy, Mendoza, you hit on the concentration factor, which tends to be a problem with Ramiro, but Posada's got him working very quickly. Just a bit low, and it's 3-1. I think we can develop that a little more on his scouting report. He can cruise along for about 3-4 innings, and then it's all of a sudden he's like it's a different pitcher. He outside, and a one-out walk to Offerman.
Needs better command of his off-speed pitches. Sometimes he can't get them over, falls behind on the count. Then they sit on the sinker, and when he has to throw a strike, sometimes they come up and they get hit hard.
And the caught in between really is his role on this ball club. He's still a pitcher that I don't think the Yankees are sure whether he is better suited to start. If you look at his record, his numbers the last couple years, he's much more effective out of the bullpen. Here's Hal Morris. In for a strike. You called him the creeper, Kenny, because of his footwork, and he honestly does not realize he does that. It's something he's done his whole career. He concentrates so much on balance, keeping his shoulders level and seeing the ball, that what he does with his feet, he doesn't even think about. And that's a Hal Morris type of swing. I mean, he is the epitome of the left-hand hitter that will hit down on the ball and drive it to left field as opposed to fly balls and pop-ups.
You mentioned not even thinking about what his feet are doing. I wonder if some of the great dancers over the years, their feet just did it. You know,
yeah. Gregory Hines, I don't think he's saying, let's see, where does this foot go, that foot go?
Yeah.
average now down to 414. That's since he left the Yankees. He got his first hit as a Yankee, 1988, slide step, and that's fouled at the plate, one and two. But over 1,000 hits. He's one of those rare players since Joe D's 56-game hitting streak that has one of at least 30 games in his career.
Back in 88, he was called up three times by the Yankees, and that first hit came against Dwayne Ward of the Toronto Blue Jays. Everybody always remembers their first hit.
Remember your first one?
Yeah. Single to center field off of Steve Renko of the Expos,
who I believe is living right here in Kansas City.
He was a all Big Eight quarterback with Kansas University. His job was to hand the ball to the Kansas Comet, Gale Sayers.
Wow, pretty good duty. Hit well left field. Strawberry has it measured, and Darryl makes the catch. Offerman's going to advance as the throw came in a little late. Good heads up play by Offerman. Darryl caught that ball in deep left center and just couldn't get much on the throw, and Offerman took advantage of it.
Well, Offerman's a good base runner to begin with, and he can see the ball is fairly deep. Now, if Strawberry actually comes up throwing and accurately, he can turn around and go back, but the throw is offline, and he's in the second standing up. Here's that footwork you were talking about, Kitty.
Yeah, creeping up. That back foot moves first, and you mentioned, I don't think there's any other hitter that approaches it that way with his footwork. Here's Jeff King. Two home run game in last night's affair, both off Andy Pettit. And he is hitting in the cleanup spot today. Tony Muser has dropped Dean Palmer down to the six hole. Off speed pitch. Nothing like the sights and sounds of a ballpark on a nice afternoon like this. You know, you hear the vendors in the background.
And yeah, this is going to be the best crowd of the three-game series. What's that he's selling?
Looks like a little ice cream. Frosty malt. Hit sharply. Jeter in the hole. Played well. The throw is in time. That solid left side of the Yankee infield. Jeter makes a nice play there. And the Royals strand one here in the bottom of the first. We've played one. The Yankees lead it by a run.
Hi, Rick Majerus, coach of the Utah Utes. I've got a big appetite for sports, but an even bigger appetite for Fox Sports News.
Midnights on MSN.
Never before, possibly never again. Financing on the right side of the point. 0.9%. Financing less than 1%. 0.9% for 48 months on Taurus and Ranger. You want the car? We have the financing. 0.9% for 48 months on Taurus. You want the truck? We have the financing. 0.9% for 48 months on Ranger. You must not miss this. Hurry to your local Ford dealer.
Win all summer long with Abbott's Summer Freeze. Enter in the Summer Freeze Grand Prize drawing, and you could win a beautiful custom-built deck by Proline Construction. Look for your entry form in the May 3rd and June 14th DNC insert, your Time Warner Communications July bill, or visit any participating Abbott's to enter. But wait, there's more. Peel and win all summer long. When you buy an Abbott's sundae or milkshake, it could make you an instant winner. Abbott's Frozen Custard, always the best.
Life is tough. Every day, stress abounds. You need a chance to unwind, a chance to find your comfort zone. At the Comfort Zone, you'll find gorgeous linens and handcrafted beds. These beds are designed with unique finishes and created to last a lifetime. Choose from the largest selection in Western New York. At the Comfort Zone, you'll also find futons and futon accessories, and we have the largest selection in the area. The Comfort Zone, where quality is affordable. The Comfort Zone, Midtown Plaza.
That shot tells you what kind of day it is. Shirt sleeves, a lot of youngsters on hand. A reminder, New York Yankee baseball brought to you in part by Toyota. Every day. That's when you play this game between April and October. You play it every day, except for a rare day off here and there.
Yeah, day off so you can travel to the next town.
Jorge Posada leads it off in the second. And the first pitch low for a ball. Average down, but good power production for the amount of time Jorge plays. Foul out of play. We've talked about his swing, Kenny, and last year he tended to lift the ball. In other words, his back shoulder dropped and he got underneath the ball. I think Chris Chambliss has worked with him on keeping that swing a little level.
I saw him this afternoon before the game in batting practice, and Chris was talking to him, and he was making that movement with the trail hand of bringing the bat down through the zone like that.
Fouled out of play. Yeah, there's, unless you're a pure power hitter, a Mark McGwire type, there's not a lot of money in the air. The money is hitting those line drives on the ground and then occasionally, like Derek Jeter does, on occasionally you lift one and get it out of the ballpark. And on the hands, so far the pitching pattern would lead you to believe. Nice play. Yep. A glove, a cold drink, and a baseball.
Didn't spill a drop.
Who could ask for anything more?
Yeah, you deserve one.
The hat trick. Good splitter. And Posada down on strikes. First strike out of the game for Belcher. Let's check out our New York Marriott Marquis pitching matchup. That's how Mendoza has done against the Royals. Tim Belcher has not fared too well in his career against the Yankees. Wonder how people realize Tim Belcher actually was a Yankee when he was drafted back in 1984. Here's Brocious. Those were in the days when if you lost a free agent, and the Oakland A's lost a free agent Tommy Underwood, left-hand pitcher, he went to Baltimore, so you got a compensation pick from anybody in the league, and Oakland picked Tim Belcher off the Yankee roster back in 1984. He was the first overall pick in the draft of 83, but opted not to sign with the Minnesota Twins. Ball and a strike to Brocious. Hit well down the line and should be in for extra bases. Morris will play it out of the corner, and Brocious will have a standing double with one out here in the Yankees second.
Now you talk about your classic hanging breaking ball, and this one kind of hung up for Brocious just to jump all over it. Belcher with the delivery. The target is low and away. Looked like a splitter that kind of hung up by Dean Palmer down the line. There's a signal by third base umpire Tim Cheetah. And the Yankees have another runner in scoring position. We're right on the ball. Pitched a little bit on the outer half of the plate. But Brocious right there with the swing.
Here's Homer Bush for the second time. That's in for a strike. Sixth double of the year for Brocious. And this series has given a little insight into how Scott has returned to his 1996 form. He's using the entire field, getting some hits to right field as well as pulling the ball. Talking about the trend so far with Belcher, and you can follow the foul balls or the broken bats and tell that his object is to get ahead and pound the ball inside, try to get in on the hands. You see how durable he's been in the last 10 seasons.
Leave a trace, a trail of broken bats and sawdust.
Got him. High fastball. And Homer Bush down on strikes. That's the second out of the inning.
When a hitter comes and plays in a ball game he hadn't played in a while, Homer Bush very rarely starts for the Yankees. He tries to make the most of every swing, and you know, you get much too anxious. He's pumped up for today's game because he's starting it, and he sees the fastball. He sees it, swings at it, although it's out of the zone.
Jeter with a ground out that advanced Homer Bush and helped produce a Yankee run as Bush scored on an infield ground ball. Outside for a ball. Chris Chambliss says one of the adjustments that Derek has made, you remember fans last year how he would dive into the ball so much, especially on the outside pitch. And this year he is stepping a little more toward the pitcher. not diving into the ball as much as a result. Maybe not as many broken bats, and he's able to turn on the inside pitch a little better. Last year he didn't get his fourth home run till game 79, so he's well ahead of that. Checked that 2 years ago in his rookie year. Might end up wearing one of those shin guards if he gets too many of those. That fouled off the instep, and it's 2-1.
Last night during the rain delay, for fans who are with us, 17-minute rain delay, we were fortunate to have Buck O'Neill, former Negro League player. And I mentioned to Jeter what Buck had said about Derek, that he thought that he was playing shortstop as good as anybody he's ever seen. And there's Buck back watching today's ball game. So very impressed with Derek, and Derek was quite impressed that Buck O'Neill thought that much of it.
High compliment from a classy, knowledgeable guy. I like his new lid.
Yeah, wow.
Nice lid, Buck. Looked like Charlie Sifford. He ought to be out on the links with that hat. And he's at just about every ball game, making some notes. Heading down to that museum after today's game down on 18th and Vine. Hit on the hands. Martinez, a strong throw in time. Nice play to end the inning, and the Yankees go scoreless in the second. We head to the Royals half of the second inning. Yankees lead at 1-0.
You want a performance car, but you need a family sedan. What you need is a 98 Ford Taurus. It's got a 200 horsepower 24-valve V6 engine with more power than Camry or Accord. And it's got room for six grown-ups or plenty of kids. So if you like to think fast, but you've got to think family, then think Ford Taurus. See your Tri-State Quality Ford dealer today, where there's more to a Ford. Now, for the first time ever, you can get 0.9% APR on any new Ford Taurus. Hurry, this low 0.9 on Taurus won't...
Substance, integrity. They're the individual pieces that contribute to a greater good, making lives less worrisome, futures more secure. They are the agents of New York life. Their humanity is the stone with which this company was built. They're why New York Life is the company you keep.
Nobody does it like you.
Nobody has harnessed the power of the wind like Wind Tunnel by Hoover. A breakthrough in cleaning power. Hoover tested Wind Tunnel against other leading brands. The difference is remarkable. Others scatter much of the dirt, but Wind Tunnel channels the power of the wind, picking up more dirt than any other clean air upright. Only from
Hoover. Nobody.
Wind Tunnel by Hoover.
Does it like you.
At Chase, your company is in good company, like Gourmet Garage, a member of Tom Seaver's Business Hall of Fame. Chase, the right relationship is everything.
Well, just in case you wondered where Al Troutwig was, you thought he was down in Miami. He's masquerading today. Now, that's the San Diego Chicken performing during the game here in Kansas City. But speaking of Al Troutwig, first we'll get the leadoff hitter in the second inning here for the Royals. It's Terry Pendleton. Knicks are up by 8 in the fourth quarter with about 6 minutes to go, and that's where our colleague Al Troutwig is. And first strike, 1-1. And we want to remind you that you can watch the MSG Sports Desk playoff special edition of the Knicks Heat postgame report. That'll be tonight at 7 o'clock on MSG. Pendleton's average, one home run, the 37-year-old veteran. Outside, 3-1.
The original starting lineup had Pendleton as the third baseman and Palmer as the designated hitter. Well, as we start the ballgame, they've switched it. Palmer's at third, and TP is DHing.
And draws a walk.
Third baseman,
he's had quite a career, Terry Pendleton, 37-year-old veteran, most valuable player in 1991 as a member of the Atlanta Braves. Gold glove third baseman, But the years have caught up with the knees, the back, the hamstrings. Palmer takes high for a ball. Now here's that concentration factor we talked about. He's walked Pendleton, and first pitch to Palmer is a ball one. Ramiro seems to have maybe one inning where he has a little trouble finding that strike zone. Ripped the foul. Nice. Oh, bobbled it. Almost a nice play.
With Mendoza and with Palmer at the plate, a power hitter. When the leadoff batter has reached base against him in an inning, the opposition has scored 8 out of 9 of those innings.
So this game is 1-1. Inside corner, strike two. Well, his nickname is Brujo, and that means witch doctor. And the reason they call him that is his ball, that you never know what way it's going to move, which way it's going to move. It'll sink down and in, it'll sail. The natural stuff is there. It's just a matter of harnessing the control and keeping it down around the knees.
Is there the possibility that his ball moves too much at times?
I think it can. I think every pitcher, you'd like to have a lot of movement, but you want to have a cross seam pitch that's outside to go to just throw a strike, like right, like he had Pendleton 3-0. You want that cross seamer. And young players are taught, you were probably taught as an outfielder, to hold the ball across the wide seam because you don't get as much lateral movement. Pitchers that hold it on the narrow seam, you'd contend to get that sinking action. Just missed. The strike zone, I think, will be a little tighter today anyway. Veteran Don Dinkinger behind the plate, not known as a pitcher's umpire. The balls that are near the corner when he's back there are balls. Brian O'Nor on Friday night, the close ones were strikes. See if Pendleton is on the go here with a full count. He is. Broken bat toward third. No chance to get Pendleton at second. Brocious is throw in time to first, and that's one down in the Royals' second as Pendleton moves up the scoring position.
Tony Muser having the runner on the move avoids the possibility of a double play with Palmer at the plate and Ramiro Mendoza, of course, a ground ball pitcher. Now the tying run moves into scoring position with one out.
And a good-looking young hitter. We say young, he's 27, but baseball or major league experience, he's still a rookie. Out of Santa Ana, California, played his college ball at the Fighting Illini. Two hopper to Tino. He'll win the race to the bag and out number two as Pendleton moves up to third base.
And I think, Larry Sutton, you mentioned the inexperience of swinging at that first pitch on a sinker ball pitcher on a pitch that started out low and went lower. And all he could do was top it and get that ground ball. With sinker ball pitchers, you got to make them bring that ball up. Make them bring it up. And with an umpire like Dinkinger behind the plate, you can do it if he doesn't get the close ones called strikes.
Chris Turner will step in. Breaking ball outside. And I would think another, if you were a rookie, Kenny, you came back to the bench, one of the veterans would say, hey, the guy just went three balls on each hitter. Why don't you make him throw a couple pitches? Hit well. Left center field. Bernie Williams on the run, and the wind is going to knock this down a little bit. That looked like he was headed for the warning track. Just a long out. Mendoza escapes the second inning despite the leadoff walk. 1-0 Yankees.
For the box open.
Wanted. Drivers with good, bad, and ugly credit. No matter what your past credit history, call Auto Solutions toll free at 1-888-423-AUTO. Your reward? Pre-qualification for instant automotive credit. It's fast, it's easy, and it's absolutely free. 1-888-423-AUTO. To be pre-approved today.
The Auto Solutions Auto Loan Phone is completely automated, so it's hassle-free and completely confidential. This is your chance to reestablish your credit without the pressure of a salesman or the hassle of paperwork. First-time buyer, divorce, repossession, slow pay, even bankruptcies. Call now. Even with less than perfect credit, you can pre-qualify for the pre-owned vehicle you've always wanted. 1-888-423-AUTO. Call Auto Solutions, the loan arrangers, for your reward. 24 hours a day, 7 days a week.
Friday's always like this. This place is nuts.
Oh, yeah.
Where are those guys over there?
Oh, they're here every Friday. They're huge Weekend Outlook fans.
Oh, it's on.
Here we go.
Let's take a look at what's on tap for your weekend.
Come on, baby K. Stay cool. Come stay on, cool. Hello. Stay
warm weather. Come on.
Stay low. Stay low.
Hello. Warm weather right there.
For the weather anytime, watch the Weather Channel. On Time Warner Communications.
Stadium from the waterfall and fountain out in left center field, and a reminder that New York Yankee baseball is brought to you in part by your local Chrysler Plymouth dealers. That is the attraction for the youngsters on hand. It is the famed San Diego Chicken. I love his act, but I'd rather see it in a minor league ballpark. You referred to that between innings.
It's cute.
Yeah, players and umpires are nice enough to go along with it, but it's become very much of the attraction at minor league baseball. When you take a family to the ball game, you see a lot of extra entertainment. The entertainment up here ought to be these guys in the uniforms. And there's a couple of good ones here. Belcher against O'Neill, former teammates. First pitch in for a strike. Both members of the Cincinnati Reds. Of course, Tim Belcher in his career, because he's moved around, what gets lost a little bit is what a factor he was for the Dodgers in 1988 when they won the World Series.
He's their second best starter behind Oral Hershiser.
Off the ground in front of home plate, chopped out to Offerman. Belcher getting a lot of broken bats and a lot of ground ball outs with that fastball and splitter. That's one down in the Yankee third, and it brings up Tino Martinez. Here's your ex-manager's favorite play right here, Kenny.
Right here, two men on, and a three-run blast, and a little hop, skip, and a jump out of the box. That's Ernie Young with the last look. Good pitching, good defense, and three-run homers.
That three-run homer made it 6-2 Yankees. They win it 12-6. First pitch high for a ball. Backing up, as his ex-teammate Ken Griffey Jr. is, backing up the MVP year with a similar type start. 1-1. Now Belcher's into a little better groove. His strength, as it should be for any pitcher, is down and away. He'll pound that fastball down and away to get ahead and then come inside, throw the splitter to, there it is right there. And he's, if I were guessing right now as a hitter, I'd say you might see a splitter down and away.
You know, he's moving the ball well around on Tino, very well. Got a call strike low and away, tied him up, up and in, but he can't stay in one area too long. He's not that overpowering.
Splitter hung high, 1-2. There are some hitters, and ouch. Get out of the way, Joe. Or is that Soho?
That's Louie.
Man, he's had enough problems with his getting hit on the hands. Looked like Joe Girardi for an instant. There's the splitter, and he got it. Good sequence by Belcher. Used the fastball to get ahead and the splitter to put him away. Two down.
If there are four zones, one, two, three, four, he used all four during that at bat with Tino. Up and in, down and away, low and in. Moving the ball around and struck him out.
Good point, because that's what you have to do against the Yankee lineup. There are some lineups and some hitters where you can get a guy out one way time after time. But the Bernie Williams, O'Neill's, Martinez, you can't do that. into the bat, hit out into right field, and he's going to catch up with it. Looked for a minute like it might carry to the wall, but Sutton makes a nice running catch. Bernie hit it well, but he didn't get all of it. And the Yankees go in order in the third. We head to the Royals half of the third. Yankees lead it 1-0.
This week, the paper will be extra heavy from all the savings at McDonald's. Just look for these great money-saving coupons. You'll get big deals like a Big Mac or Quarter Pounder with Cheese Sandwich for just 99 cents. So look for the insert in your Sunday paper or mailbox. Did somebody say McDonald's?
Start spreading the news. I'm leaving today. I want to be a part of it. New York, New York. I want to wake up in a city that never sleeps. And find I'm day number one, top of the list, king of the hill, a number one. It's up to you.
For the best selection of Yankee t-shirts, hats, jerseys, jackets, and more, you gotta go to Mo's.
Gotta go to Mo's.
This week, the paper will be extra heavy from all the savings at McDonald's. Just look for these great money-saving coupons. You'll get big deals like a Big Mac or Quarter Pounder with Cheese Sandwich for just 99 cents. So look for the insert in your Sunday paper or mailbox. Did somebody say McDonald's?
Welcome back to Sunday afternoon Yankee baseball here on MSG. 1-0 Yankees. We move to the bottom of the third, and Mendoza will face young Felix Martinez. Can you imagine, Kenny, you see that average, 148, playing in the big leagues when you've only been swinging a bat for about 4 years? He was a soccer player. That's outside for a ball, and Tom Poquette, the Royals hitting coach, working with him yesterday, trying to get him to be patient, say, hey, you haven't been playing this game that long yet. They love his fielding skills and his arm. Center field, Bernie shades his eyes from the sun, puts it away, one down. And the lineup will turn over, and Johnny Damon will come up to the plate. Here's our Hoover pickup of the game. And that bailed Tim Belcher and the Royals out in the first inning. A nice grab by Johnny Damon.
Third time in his career he had four hits in the ballgame. Of course, that came last night.
2-0 now. If he played in the 50s, he'd be linked with Frankie Avalon and Frankie Valli and Johnny Damon. Sounds like he ought to be singing in that era. Ground foul, 2-1.
Maybe that on Vine Street here in Kansas.
That's right. Yeah. Buck O'Neill, get him in the Jazz Hall of Fame down there. He's got one of those wiry, live bodies. The ball jumps off his bat. He's got terrific speed. Played his high school baseball down in Dr. Phillips High School, Orlando, Florida.
He's going to play every day against lefties and righties and bat right where he is now, leading off.
It's the only way you will become a good player and get the ability to hit both kinds of pitching. And the Royals can afford to do that. I mean, this guy's got to be one of their marquee players down the road. You mentioned last night Bob Boone tended to shelter Damon a little bit, put him down in the lineup, didn't play him against all lefties. Now he's in there every day. Hit well in the gap in right center, but O'Neill's going to get over there in a hurry and put it away.
A little unusual for Ramiro Mendoza, as Johnny Damon has flied out three fly ball outs in a row, two to center, one to right. And Jose Offerman having trouble with the donut. I've had trouble with donuts so during my life too.
That donut is that metal ring, and actually I'm trying to think of the exact year. I want to say back in the late 60s, but the gentleman that gets credited for inventing that donut is the late Elston Howard.
Yeah, that's right.
It was metal, and then they came up with a nice rubber or vinyl coating to go over it, and that is what the hitters use in the batting circle. Reminder, as we get into the fourth inning, Susan Waldman will join us during the middle innings and fill us in on her story of the week, player of the week, and a lot of interesting things that go on in Yankee land. 2-0 to Offerman.
You notice that Offerman wears number 30. He was given number 30 when he joined the Dodgers, when he got called up. And that was the number that Maury Wills used to wear with the Dodgers. That shows you how much they thought of Offerman as a potential shortstop for a long time. Well, eventually he got over here to Kansas City, still wears number 30.
For a strike, 3-1, and has become a very good second baseman.
Played a little bit at first until Jeff King nailed down the job.
Grounded out towards second. Homer Bush is there, so Mendoza comes back from the 3-0 count. The Royals go in order for the first time today. We've got three in the books here at Kauffman Stadium. Pitchers in charge of this one. It's 1-0 Yankees.
10 seconds remaining. Allen Houston at three. Bang! Allen Houston ties it up.
You're watching MSG Network.
We're all over it.
We're bored. Can we do something tonight?
Costs too much to do something.
Well, how about going to a movie?
$11,200 to see a movie.
Can we go bowling?
How many games?
Two.
$9,720.
Ouch. I've got it. We'll order pay-per-view.
Pay-per-view. The whole family, one low price. Now that adds up.
Come on, kids, gather round.
The whole gang can do it when you pay-per-view it.
Each year, the Wegmans Rochester International plays host to the top names in women's golf, presenting this year's winners. Every year, proceeds from the tournament support the Rotary Sunshine Camp and Camp Hackamo. So, when you buy a ticket to the Wegmans Rochester International, not only are you seeing world-class golf, you're helping some very special kids enjoy their summer. The Wegmans Rochester International. For ticket information, call 427-7100.
I sell this place all the time to my friends.
The first thing we wanted to look at and see was the swimming pool. That was the only thing we thought about.
The first time I walked into one of the apartments, I was in awe. Marketplace is about 10 minutes away, and Wegmans is probably about 2 minutes. It's wonderful. I don't have to worry about a furnace. I don't have to worry about a roof. I don't have to worry about my appliances breaking. They take care of all that.
Blueberry Hill Apartment Homes off Route 252, where living is truly carefree.